things have been hard around here lately. I seem like I've been distant from you a lot of times. And I know it hurts you. And I know that I should become a better man. Well, I have something for you. And before you leave, there's just one thing I want to say. It's a little poem that I read.
You wrote a poem?
Mm-hmm. I wrote a poem.
Did you read it?
I have memorized it in my head. It was once said that I was sad. While others told me that I needed to be glad, there is that one missing soul that can heal you all. It's never too late to look for your one true loving mate. Sit from the stars above, granting you your whole life's wish, from happiness to sadness, to put up with everything you do, and go through the roller coaster with you as it spins around and around, holding each other tight, from laughing to crying. Our adventure starts now. Forget about your old adventures. Embrace what you have. Make with it from there. Because the skies are still blue. She's the one that makes you kind, even though your anger makes you blind. It brings up the tears and joy. Forever by her I will stand. Now for the next part. Michaela Dawn Renee Jones, would you make me the happiest man from the time we say I do? The time we get sick and ailing and nurture each other, to the day we turn gray and cry, saying our last goodbye. Would you marry me?
My face.
Let me reassure you this much. I don't care if the cameras are rolling or not. The one thing is, I'm gonna bust my ass. Not just for one person. Strife off my hard work that I've done for 10 years. To be honest with you, I've been dying to share my legacy with someone, not a friend, about that.
But now,
I'm surprised I kept it from you this long.
But now you didn't know.
That was the whole surprise. Nothing. No distance. No water. No fire. No smoke. Or fog. Can keep us apart from one another. One way or another, we always come back. And I know what you've always told me. You have never promised tomorrow. But I have a saying too. You fight for that tomorrow. I know how you felt whenever I was cooped up in there. But in my mind, I said one day, just give it a little bit more time, Pat. Give it a little bit more time. And tell her. Tell her. It's my time to tell her. I'm building. And when we have children, we'll pass down that legacy to them. When we're gone, when we're both buried next to each other. You know it's true.
This is true.
Yeah.
You are.
Yeah. And you think for a second, if you were say if you live all this family. Tell me no. I tell them not to do it anyway. Give them my love. I'll do anything and everything I can in my power as a human being to keep you with me.
No.
You can do it all whenever you want me. I'm not halfway done.
You're not halfway done.
Yeah, that's why I'm saying that. Everything within those eyes. And whenever you're gone, obviously, maybe you're gone. And I get lost in your eyes. Exhaling into calm, charred waters. There's no tidal wave. There's nothing. You can just hear the ocean. And that calm, gentle breeze against your face. That's what you do to me. That's what you are to me. You're like a bell. first met, my heart was broken. But as you can see in this drawing, you are fixing it into a new heart. Thank you, Matthew. I love you beyond what words can say. Forever, always. Forever and always. Kayla, 11/2/17. Very first thing you gave me. The cracked heart with chipped pieces that still may be put together. With this chipped piece, this represents home. This chipped piece means our future. This whole heart represents us. Fractures are the people that try to come between us, but we stay strong. And the blood represents blood, sweat, and tears that we put into this, our relationship. In this piece right here, that is not covered with cracks, are the people that support us, that we keep close, and that make sure that we stay here forever. Then I remember getting this. November 26, 2017. Read this when you have time. I love you, Mr. Gilliland, which is me. Yeah. And whenever I first heard it slide in my door, I picked that up immediately. Gilliland said to me was, I fell in love with all of you.
You know.
Yeah. I'm gonna read back your words. Matthew, I want you to know something. I fell in love with all of you. And just fall in love with the best of you. So that's, yeah, like the way your eyes light up and light up the room. The way your laugh makes me giggle. The way your hand fits into mine. The way your personality stands out. The way your smile gives me butterflies. Or the way your body moves. I fell in love with all of you. I fell in love with your scars. The way you make sarcastic remarks. The way you feel helpless at 2 a.m. The way you cry about something from years ago. The way you can sometimes get angry. Or the way you sometimes want to be alone. I fell in love with all of you. And I fell in love with the great. What is that? That looks like it's him.
Great. I fell in love with the great in you, and I fell in love with the bad you see in yourself. But the bad you see is the great that I see, because I love every part of you, every little bit of you. I fell in love with all of you, Matthew Thomas Jr.
Always yours, Michaela. I sent you one, and like texting, got another reply. To my forever happiness from your soon-to-be wife. I don't know if those are still rolling or not. Matthew, well, you were right. That note made me tear up, almost cried my eyes out. I'd never let you go through Yeah, I've met you many times, but now it's just, go ahead.
Matthew, you're right. That note made me tear up, almost cried my eyes out. I've never let you go through anything alone, ever. Unless you tell me you don't want me anymore. And I pray every night that I never hear you say that. Because if you ever did, I would be nothing again. You're everything to me, Matt. Since the day we met, everything has changed for me. It was like my world was upside down and you came in and now it's upside right. I fell in love with you all over every day. Nothing could ever change the way I feel about you. You're a dream come true. I prayed for nights that someone would come along and love me, and God gave me you. And I can't wait until February 28th, 2018, then you'll really be mine for good. And I'm madly in love with all of you. Every little piece. Everything you talk bad about yourself. I fell in love with the way you did you, the way you fart in bed. And that won't ever change. Every couple fights. We get to places where we need to be apart, but we don't need to be apart. We're better together. Every day I spend. When I'm not with you, I think about you. Think about what's the next thing we're going to do together, the next video we're going to make. Next thing I'm going to cook for you.
And you know, this one took months. A lot. Now that I got this plan out, and now that I got you into this plan, now that you learned it, I am crafty like that. I do things when you least expect them. Whenever I act distant now, to be honest, when I act distant, I'm playing something. Not mischievous. Never.
Sometimes.
This was probably mischievous, but you know.
It was a good surprise.
Yeah. No. I did not like the first time I proposed to you. So in my head, I'm like, I was too fucking drunk. So in my head, I'm like, yeah, this is going to take a lot of planning, and I need to do it when I should be expensive.
That doesn't mean we have to move the marriage license back, does it?
No.
Okay.
No.
Can we move it forward?
Forward, yeah.
And a month ahead?
A month ahead.
January 28th. Start to the year.
I don't know where I'm going.
I don't know.
was my main support. Dad whispered to me, and me only. No help.
Is that it?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.